everything's asynchronous. Well, it is on a mobile phone. You don't want your movie interrupted while you're waiting for the result of a sensor, or you're waiting for something else to happen. There's so many things going on, so many technologies on the mobile phone, so many things that you're waiting for. You don't want to make the user wait for something to return a result. So everything's asynchronous. So what we do is we send off an asynchronous request and we wait in our event handler to get the response back. So it's all done asynchronously. So how is that done in bada? Well, we use listeners. And we register a listener for a particular event. So in this case, we have the proximity sensor. You know what the proximity sensor is? It detects it when you hold your phone up to your ear to switch off the screen, for example. So here, what we're doing is we're checking to see if the proximity sensor is available, and then we're adding a listener. Now, this is a method of the form. So the form is actually going to act as the listener. So whenever there's an event for this particular sensor, the form is going to get to be told about it. So we're calling addSensorListener, and we're passing this. So we're passing the form to that method. Well, how does that work? Surely it can't know. You can't have known in advance that you wanted to work with a sensor. So this is how it's defined. We make sure that our form derives from our sensor listener, and the listener classes are interface classes. They're interface classes which consist of a bunch of pure virtual functions that you are responsible for implementing. So if you have an object that wants to act as a listener, for example, our form here wants to receive events from the sensor, it has to derive from the sensor listener, and it has to implement the methods that the sensor listener defines. And luckily for us here, we've only got one method on data receive. So that will be called whenever there's data from the sensor. And in our on data receive method, it's called, we implement it, and we check the value of the sensor, and we go and do some processing. If we're drawing this comparison to Symbian C++, this would be like, for example, active objects. We have active objects that we wrap around asynchronous calls, and we have the runL method, which is called when asynchronous call returns. So everything's asynchronous. Listeners is a very important idiom. So just quickly, I mentioned web applications and Flash applications. These are two alternatives to just doing pure C++. So if you've got some web code, you can create a web application with a mixture of JavaScript, HTML, CSS. And it creates the C++ code for you, and you can just add to that JavaScript and that HTML file. And also you can have Flash applications. So if you've got, how many people here do anything with Flash on mobile? Okay, so you'll be familiar with FlashLite. So if you have maybe some games in FlashLite and using FlashLite in ActionScript, if you create an SWF file built with FlashLite 3.1 and ActionScript 2.0, you can use that in bada. And let's have a look. And this is just a very quick movie which is showing you how you create a web-based application. We use the Project Wizard. We select web-based application. Some of these steps have been speeded up. It creates all the C++ code for creating the web control, and it creates two files for us, main.js and index.html, so JavaScript file and HTML file. We would then add to those, add our own code to those, to create our web application. And the same thing with Flash, we create a new Flash application. And now here, we actually choose the SWF file that we've built with ActionScript and FlashLite. This is the code that it generates for us. It gets the Flash control, and then we just build it, and it then interacts with the Flash. And the great thing actually about using Flash in bada is that it's easy to communicate both from Flash to the bada API calls and the other way around, from the bada APIs to Flash. So we use, anybody who's familiar with ActionScript, we can use the fs command to ActionScript, which would send information from Flash to bada, and then we send it the other way using the Flash control method send data event to ActionScript. So don't worry too much about the details. The important thing is that you can port over your FlashLite-based games or user interface, which are based on Flash, and port those to bada, which is just an alternative to having to do everything the C++ way. So we have a bunch of standard technologies. OpenGL ES 1.1 and 2.0. So if you've got some code, again, that's very useful for if you've got game development. SQLite, one of my personal favorites. I think just about every other mobile platforms, if you've got databases on the device, you'll be using SQLite. Bada implements that. It's very like the Symbian classes. It's also very similar to the way that iOS does it and some of the Android classes do it. So if you've got some database code, it's very easy to move that across to Bada. And we have a bunch of networking classes. So we've got HTTP. Client support, DNS resolution, Bluetooth and Wi-Fi. These are all in the net namespace, so if you want to have a look at how those are implemented, that's where you find those. XML parsing, this is actually a really, really useful namespace. So if you're getting some XML back, for example, if you've done getting something from Facebook or another social networking application, you want to parse it. There's an XML namespace that makes it actually quite easy to do that on Bada. And unit testing, which is one of Manfred's personal favorites. There is a testing namespace that was introduced in Bada 1.1 and includes various standard tests, which you'll find in other environments as well. So if you've got some testing code, you can move that across to Bada as well. Right, okay, I'll just breeze through this very quickly. What I wanted to say about this is mention the way that Bada implements platform security. It's quite different to the old Symbian approach where we had 20 or so capabilities and access to particular functions that would either access the user's data or spend the user's money were controlled by those capabilities, some of which could be allowed by the user and some of which you would actually have to obtain and then sign into your application. The way that Bada works is certain APIs are part of a privileged group. Certain APIs have no privileges required at all, but some of the APIs you either have a normal or a system privilege. Now, the ones that are covered by the system privilege, very, very few. It's usually the ones that involve spending the user's money. So sending an SMS message, for example, that's covered by a system privilege. If you want your application to have that particular bit of functionality, you have to make sure that it has that particular privilege, which is a system privilege. The way you specify privileges in your application is when you create an application manifest on the developer site, it will actually give you a list of privileges to select from. And depending on your status, whether you're just a standard developer or you're a Samsung partner, will determine whether or not you can have normal privileges or system privileges. But one thing to say is that quite recently they changed things so that most of the functionality of the Bada platform is protected by normal privileges. There's only very few APIs that are protected by system privileges. And that's basically it. So we've sped this up a bit, but I just wanted to say that your knowledge of other platforms is going to give you a head start with Bada. This is actually a version of our series of blog posts. So if you want to go through this in more detail, then look at the SAMI blog. We serialized this in three parts. If you want to, it's giving it all in gory detail. So have a look at the SAMI blog if you want more details on it. We've got a familiar development environment, a familiar development language. We've got some idioms that you might have seen before, like two-phase construction, for example. You can use web applications and Flash. You can build some of that, bring some of that code over to Bada. You've got standard technologies, which, again, make it easier for you to bring your existing code over to Bada. So this is the bit you're waiting for. Quiz time. Which namespace was introduced in Bada 1.1? That was very quick. Hold on, you don't move for a second. Oh, right, okay. Okay.
Should we go with that?
Okay, yeah, no, it's the test namespace. Well done.